Today we're going to talk about dog teeth care, and we're going to show you how we take care of our dog's teeth. So when it comes to tools, we have our dental tools we got from Amazon. It was like $9 for a set. More come in the set, but I really only use these three. And then a firm bristle toothbrush and an enzyme toothpaste. This is made specifically for dogs because dogs can't have fluoride. So these are the three of the set that I like to use the most. The one on the right is my go-to one that I use the most often. And then the one in the middle is my kind of cleanup one. But I use the one on the left just depending on the spot and if I need a different angle to get to the tartar. You can do a homemade dog safe toothpaste. You can look up recipes online, but it's pretty much baking soda and mint essential oils if you wanted. First, you want to get yourself and your dog into the right position. This is my favorite position, where you have them between your legs, feet up. It's the same position that I do when I Dremel their nails. And when I'm doing their grooming, I'll Dremel their nails and then I'll just jump over and do their teeth. This video is just on their teeth. When you do this from when they're puppies, like 8 weeks old, you first get them. If you do this starting when they're super young, by the time they get older, they'll do it without fighting or thrashing or anything. They still fight a little bit, especially when they do their, when you're actively dremeling or actively, you know, chipping away at the tartar. But for the most part, they're really good. If you haven't done this with your dog since they were a puppy, give it a shot, but you want to be careful because if they thrash a lot, they can, you know, hit you back and hit your head and make your head hit the back wall. So you want to make sure you're only doing this if you know that you can do it safely. If you can't, you can always try kind of a different hold. There are a lot of great videos on YouTube of like vet tech holds you can try, but if you don't trust your dog enough to not thrash when you're holding them in this kind of position, then you most likely aren't going to be able to trust your dog enough to put your fingers in their mouth and to chip out their tartar and plaque. For dogs with larger mouths like Dobermans, you're going to be mainly looking at their molars, a few of their premolars, and their canines. Their incisors really don't collect tartar and plaque like small dogs' mouths do and like their bigger teeth do. We shined a flashlight on their teeth so that way you can see the tartar and plaque and the teeth staining a little bit better. The dark yellow, that's tartar, where it's a little bit of a lighter shade of yellow, or maybe not yellow, maybe more whitish. That's going to be plaque. Plaque is just food and whatever they've been chewing on outside that just hasn't hardened into tartar yet. And then some of it is just going to be staining. You're not going to be able to scrape that off. It's just from, comes with age. It's no big deal, and it doesn't contribute to their bad breath or to their gum and teeth health, which is all I'm really concerned about. These, they can, but the main development of periodontal disease is from the tartar building up, especially at the gum line, pushes the gum up and basically makes it recede. And then there's not enough, once all the plaque's been removed, there's not enough keeping the tooth in place, so it has to be pulled. And these are what really healthy, good gums look like. And when I brush and when I chip away at the tartar, you're not gonna see inflammation, you're not gonna see bleeding or anything like that because they're really well taken care of. So use what technique and tools you're comfortable with and what makes sense for what, which teeth you're doing. Notice how with my hand, I'm lifting up her, I'm holding her snout with one hand, and with the same hand, I'm also kind of lifting her lip up. That leaves my other hand free to work and manipulate. I'm always scraping away from the gums. If you're doing it properly, it's going to be pain-free to them because you're just taking off plaque and tartar. You're not injuring their gums and you're not hurting them. It's only going to be uncomfortable, and the only uncomfortableness is going to come from them being on their back in kind of an awkward position. So if they want to switch sides, I'll just let them switch sides and I'll just start working on the other teeth where I left off. It's a lot easier doing this way to work with them rather than forcing them to stay in one position for too long. They're going to be more uncomfortable. They're going to get impatient. So you might as well just go for the flow. And really, once you get into the habit of doing this, you're not going to have to do very much. And if you want to see what's causing your dog's bad breath, it's this tartar. Each one of those specks does not smell very good. and each one of the chunks that come off. They don't smell very good. I just wipe them onto a rag and then keep going. But you're gonna, once you do this, you're gonna notice a huge difference in your dog's breath. All right, then after you're done scraping, you wanna just move on to a basic teeth brushing. I like to brush in this position as well. So I don't get them up and then brush. I like to keep them in this position and then brush. I feel like I can just get more leverage and a better angle. So it's real simple. You don't have to be too gentle. Their gums are really hard. And if you're not, you don't have to worry about gum receding or anything because you're not gonna do this that often. So brush away and you should get kind of the last remainder specks of some tartar, and then hopefully you can get all of the plaque off as well. All right, so that's basically it, how to take care of your dog's teeth. Now the dog's obviously uncomfortable and they would probably rather this not happen, but compared to the risks of putting your dog under, it's much preferable, and there's no real risk involved like there is with the dog going under anesthesia or sedation, where there's a risk of them not waking up or aspirating or something like that. This is Strawberry. You can see one of her baby teeth still in her mouth. For her, because obviously she's so young, she doesn't have any tartar, so I'll just do a teeth brushing, you know, every week, every couple of weeks. One, it keeps her breath fresh and keeps tartar from forming on her adult teeth that are coming in, but it also gets her used to it now. So that way when she's older, it's gonna be no big deal because she's already been used to it. We're big with our puppy buyers on telling them, whatever you want them to do when they're older, you need to do it when they're a puppy and get them used to it. If you have any questions, you can post it down below. We'll definitely answer anything that we can. We'll talk to you later.